talk about some of the hardware and software requirements for vSAN. When we think about vSAN, we automatically think about storage. But we also need to think about not only our disks, we need to think about our RAID controllers, we need to think about our memory, which is very, very important. We need to think about our CPUs, we need to think about licensing, the number of hosts that are supported, our VMs being HA protected. So what we are actually going to do now is we are going to whiteboard a vSAN host. So here is a host that we have sitting in a vSAN cluster. So this is my ESXi host. On my ESXi host, I can have SSDs. And in this example, let's say that these SSDs can do 100,000 IOPS. And let's say that this is an all-flash configuration. So since this is an all-flash configuration, I can have other SSDs in my capacity tier that will be 30K IOPS. So this here would be my cache tier. And this here is my capacity tier. When you look in the VMware compatibility guide, the VMware compatibility guide will actually tell you where your disks should sit, because you do not want your disks